Hey guys, I've been working over the summer and the past, 7 or 8 months on a new type of 1.5 volt AA battery inverter, and I was able to come up with something that's my final project. I was testing a lot of different toroids between CPU toroids or choke toroids and different things, and I kept coming back to this one, and this was from a 1983 RCA television, and I found that the best toroids for these types of inverters, usually they're in a plastic encapsulating packaging. So I thought that they used to be just air core if they were like plastic coil forms, but inside there's a very dense toroid, and I found that that definitely works the best with GDTs and even these inverter circuits. But this inverter does put out about 300-400 volts, and probably up to about 300 milliamps. That's the maximum current draw. And I added a little potentiometer here, 7.8K, I believe, to adjust the power output. And this goes, it adjusts the current going to the base of the transistor. Transistor is a tip 32 from Radio Shack. And the toroid is a 15 turn, I believe. Yeah, 15 turns, center tapped at 4. So that'd be, 4 and 11. And it's got the 4 turns going to the base. The 11 turns going to the collector. On top, I originally wound about 75 turns of 30 gauge wire. Then I took some MOT wire, which is about 28 gauge, and I wound an extra 120 turns on top of that. And then I added another, 50 to 60 turns on top of that. So I kept winding more and more, and I epoxy coated the whole thing, so it looks very nice. And I added an AC plug for an output, and I glued on top of this heatsink. Now, this is the final circuit. You've seen my high voltage Joule Thief inverter. This is much better than that one. This one definitely puts out a much higher voltage, and you can also get some sparks between those two electrodes, which is what I'm going to try to get at now. So I'm going to turn the lights off to show you the sparks. One thing to be wary of, the toroids that I tested had a very low resonant frequency, and this means that it creates a noise when resonating, so you'll be able to hear it. It's a higher pitch, somewhere 17 kilohertz maybe. I'll try to stabilize this plasma arc. If you touch the two prongs, which I'm not going to do, you do get a nasty, annoying shock. So, it's something you want to not do. Here we have an LED bulb. 0.5 watts, 3 SMD LEDs in there, surface mount. So just plug it into the output. To lift this up to plug it in. Turn it on, and it is amazingly bright. I will do a comparison between this brightness and the brightness of my first Joule Thief, but this is amazingly bright. Definitely no doubt about it. The camera's adjusting itself to the light, but it's super bright. It's illuminating most of the room. And if you see, I can turn this potentiometer knob. I can control the current being consumed. So that's maybe about 50 milliamps. My bad. It's about 100 right there. And then the full brightness at a couple hundred. So that'll last for about 3 hours. on this light because it's not drawing a ton. Now this one is a 2-watt LED bulb from Target. This one lights up nicely. Oops. This one, you can see, it, I don't know why it's showing some flickering on the camera. Because the camera doesn't like 60 hertz. But this isn't really flickering, even though it shows like lines going across. That's not actually happening in real life. This one's probably the best. That one or the one before it, but this one does provide a light glow to the whole room. Evenly distributed light, while the other light bulb is more focused. I do have a couple other things. I want to charge off. I got a charger here. It does work with a camera. I've tested it. But as you can see, the charging light does light up, even though there's nothing attached to it. I know that, but it does charge small cameras like my watch camera. And then, I have your ever-popular 4-watt fluorescent tube. Plug this in. The thing about this one is you got to touch the neutral side to get it to go, but it does go. Adjust it slightly. There we go. And that's, I mean, not expecting a lot of light out of that. That's still, it's pretty good. It lights up whatever you're working on. It could be like an little overhead lamp for when the power goes out, but that's 4 watts. And that's pretty much it. I've hooked this up to a voltage multiplier and get about 3,000 volts DC with my 16-stage voltage multiplier, so. It's not enough for a March generator. I have to build another voltage multiplier, probably another 16-stage, and get about 6 kilovolts, and that should do the trick. So this thing definitely is good for many different purposes. And once again, it's been something that's 8 months in the making.